So central serous keratinopathy is still a very challenging disease without an established standard therapy yet. Today I would like to share our experience with a subliminal laser. We have two forms of CSC. You see here the acute one, which comes with a subretinal fluid accumulation and is typical pinpoint leakage in the angiography. Since it's often regress spontaneously, a direct treatment is not always necessary. But we also have the chronic form you see here. This chronic form comes out also sometimes with subretinal fluid accumulation, but what we also see is a severe structural damage, and we would like to treat our patients before this irreversible structural damage occurs. We have different treatment options for CSC. Observation without the treatment is an option in the early cases, but if we wait too long, there's a risk of chronification and irreversible structural damage. Anti-VEGF seems not to work for CSC, only in cases with CNV formation as a side effect. A conventional photocoagulation has a high risk of scotoma and CNV formation and also reduction of contrast sensitivity. So we would not recommend to do this treatment for CSC. Half-dose photodynamic therapy has shown to be very effective in treating CSC patients, but there's also the risk of RPE atrophy, CNV formation, and scotoma. So not all surgeons are comfortable with treating with PDT for the early CSC. The subliminal laser treatment is shown to also be effective in CSC treatment, and the most important thing is there are no side effects with the subliminal laser treatment. I already told you the CSC can regress spontaneously. We normally choose to wait 6 weeks or a little bit longer for treating our patients. But there are also a few reasons where an earlier treatment could be considered. For example, visual impairment due to CSC on the other eye, or a recurrence of the detachment, and also a need for a rapid visual improvement, maybe for professional reasons, could be a reason. Also, a high level of suffering from the patient could be a call for an early treatment. We use the subliminal laser treatment in Cologne since 2012 for treating our patients. Previously, we mainly used a half-dose photodynamic therapy. To evaluate our treatment success and also to compare it with the photodynamic therapy, we performed two retrospective studies in Cologne. The first one, we included 38 patients treated with the 577 nanometer suprascan laser. Patients with any prior treatment in the last 3 months were excluded in this study. The mean follow-up was 5 months. At the last follow-up, 74% of the patients responded to therapy. There was also a significant decrease in central retinal thickness and a significant increase in best-corrected visual acuity. There was no laser burns detected with any imaging modality. What you see here are survival curves. On the left hand, you see the morphological response, and on the right, the functional response. And what you see is that the morphological response kicks in much more faster than the functional response. So it's always good to tell the patient about this fact, otherwise they will be concerned after a few weeks if the functional response is not kicked in yet. We also included a subgroup of patients which are resistant to our prior half-dose PDT session. In this group, 31% of the patients responded to the therapy. And there was also a significant decrease in central retinal thickness, but no significant increase in best-corrected visual acuity in those patients. After we have shown that the subthreshold laser treatment is effective in treating CSC patients, we wanted to compare it to our prior standard therapy, the half-dose photodynamic therapy. So we again conducted a retrospective study. We included this time 100 patients, 42 of them treated with the suprascan laser and 58 with the PDT. Patients with any prior treatment were excluded in this study. The follow-up was 6 weeks. So 6 weeks after the therapy, there was a significant decrease in central retinal thickness in both groups. But the decrease in central retinal thickness was higher after subliminal laser. And only the subliminal laser group showed a significant increase in best-corrected visual acuity after the treatment. And also the overall treatment response was higher after subliminal laser. And importantly to know, in both groups, an additional treatment of the same category increased the treatment response rate. So it's not always necessary to switch the treatment after one unsuccessful treatment. Especially in subliminal laser, there's always a possibility of an under-treatment in the first place. We also performed a safety check for both treatments. In the subliminal laser group, there were no structural changes or laser burns detectable. And I would like to add, since this is a short study with only 6 weeks of follow-up, also no other longer studies showed any side effects after subliminal laser treatment. In the half-dose PDT group, there was one patient with a CNV formation after the treatment, and one other patient suffered from a moderate allergic reaction during the treatment. Also in the PDT group, after 6 weeks, we did not see any structural changes, but I would like to add, other studies with longer follow-up periods showed side effects like RPE atrophy, CNV formation, and choroidal ischemia. Besides our two own studies, we recently published a review article about subthreshold micropulse laser treatment in different macular diseases. So we gave an overview about the current literature for CSC, DME, and also retinal vein occlusion, and performed an evaluation of the current evidence for the treatment in each field. Today, I would like only to show the CSC data here. We weighted an average of the change in central retinal thickness and in best corrected visual acuity according to the number of patients included in each study. And what you see here is that the change in central retinal thickness was highest after subliminal laser treatment, followed by PDT treatment, and there was almost no change after observation. The same for the change in best corrected visual acuity. It was highest after subliminal laser treatment, followed by PDT, and almost no change after observation. Also, the subliminal laser treatment showed the highest efficacy for CSC treatment in all included studies, and 64% of the patients showed no more subretinal fluid after the treatment compared to 46% after PDT and only 8% after observation. No included study reported any complications after up to 5 subliminal laser treatment sessions. So an early treatment could be considered for potentially better results. Now I would like to show a few patients. The first one here, you see this amount of subretinal fluid at baseline. We performed a subliminal laser treatment, and 8 weeks after the treatment, we see a reduction in subretinal fluid. At this point, we always have to think about, do we need another treatment or wait? For this patient, we waited, and it seems to be the right choice because 12 weeks after treatment, the subretinal fluid was gone without an additional treatment. But as we see here in the next patient, at baseline, he had this huge amount of subretinal fluid. We treated like you see here. And 6 weeks after the treatment, centrally, there was no more subretinal fluid. But at the upper vascular arcade, there was this residual part of fluid. Also, again, we decided to wait in this patient, but this time it seems to be the wrong decision. Only 3 months after the first treatment, the patient returned to our clinic with, again, the subretinal fluid formation. So we performed a second treatment, and 6 weeks after the treatment, the subretinal fluid disappeared completely. The next patient did not get a sublingual treatment in the first place. We started here with PDT treatment. 8 weeks after the treatment, the subretinal fluid gets a little bit. It was reduced a little bit. So we performed a second treatment, but there was no change at all. Then we switched to subliminal laser treatment, and 8 weeks after the treatment, we see here a completely dry retina. So in conclusion, the subliminal laser treatment is effective and safe treatment for CSC. There's a better treatment response after subliminal laser compared to PDT. This is effective even in patients with failed PDT. There are no structural damages or side effects after subliminal laser treatment, but a retreatment is possible and often necessary. The subliminal laser treatment is possible after PDT, but also a PDT after subliminal laser treatment. There are also some patients which seems to work better the subliminal laser therapy or the PDT. And because of the excellent safety profile of the subliminal laser treatment, an early treatment could be considered for potentially better results and to avoid permanent structural damage and lasting visual acuity. So thank you very much for your attention again.